Here's three super simple tricks that look like magic, but are actually based on science. Make a ring move with your mind, balance a can on its side, and burn a piece of paper without it burning. Now to magically make my magic hat appear, and to start the show. Make a ring move with your mind. For this trick, you'll need a rubber band that's been cut in half, and an ordinary ring. Why use an ordinary ring when you can use Lego Batman? As I focus really carefully, Batman starts to move up the rubber band all by himself. Whoa! So how do you do it? And how does it work? Place Batman about 2.5 centimeters from one end of the rubber band. Put this part of the rubber band between your thumb and the side of your finger so that this part of the rubber band is hidden from sight. Hold this end of the rubber band with your other hand and stretch the rubber band as far as you can. Then slowly let this end slide through your fingers. That's all you have to do. Rubber bands are elastic. This means they stretch when you pull on their ends, but return to their original shape when you stop pulling the ends. In this case, moving Batman along too. Balance a can on its side. Next time you're out for dinner and a can of drink magically appears, ask someone to try balancing the can on its side. When they can't do it, open the can, drink 2/3, and then balance it on its side. This is the can's center of mass when it's 1/3 full. The force of gravity acts straight down on the center of mass, and because it's over the flat part of the can, it doesn't topple over. But when the can is full, the center of mass is here, so the force of gravity makes it topple over. Burn a piece of paper without it burning. For my last trick, take an ordinary piece of paper and set it on fire. You'll see the paper burns for a short time and then stops burning. Let's try that again. Awesome! The secret to this trick is soaking the paper in a mixture of 50% isopropyl alcohol. That's 1/4 cup of isopropyl alcohol mixed with 1/4 cup of water. Add 2 teaspoons of table salt so that it will burn with an orange flame. As the isopropyl alcohol burns, it heats up both the water and the paper. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius, and as it boils, it removes a lot of this heat. So long as there's water left on the paper won't get any hotter than 100 degrees Celsius. This is less than the temperature at which paper burns, so the paper doesn't catch on fire. The drops falling from the paper may also be on fire, so make sure you use a tray and have nothing else flammable around. Bonus magic trick. This paper is pretty indestructible. If I rip it up into tiny little pieces just like this, and then scrunch these up into a ball, the paper returns to normal. Whoa! I got a couple of these tricks from Kevin Quantum's YouTube channel. If you want to find out how to do the last trick, make sure you click the link in the description. Thanks for watching this episode of Silly Science with Simon.